All right. I'm out on a Yutani excavator today.
And has a complaint with this side track here, the machine's left side track. it was binding up. It wouldn't move a little bit. Once you kind of got it going one way, it would keep going that way. If you tried to reverse direction, it would lock up again. It was loading the engine, so I knew it was developing pressure, and the customer replaced a part on it, and the part was the park brake control valve. Now, here's our motor in here. Okay, I have the park brake control valve unbolted already, now that I've located what I believe the problem is. So what these do is, there's typically four lines on any track drive motor. So you have a little line up here, high, low, selector line. Put pressure to it, put it in high, relieve the pressure, puts the motor in low. It changes the displacement of the motor. You got this line here. This is your case drain, because all motors leak into their case a little bit. It's inherent. They're not sealed perfectly. So rather than have to force the oil back out through the return line or whatnot, they add an additional case drain, keeps the pressure low, keeps you from blowing seals out. Then on here goes a valve that controls the motor's brake effectively. Now, I got my two lines back here plugged, so that your A and B, your A and your B come into this valve block, and then you have a case drain and a park brake release. So these work like maxi brakes, where they're spring applied, pressure releases them, so you got to put pressurized oil into one of these ports here to release the brake. Now, this thing had a weird kind of condition. It would release and run fine, or it would stay on. So it was leak by, and it got actually, the customer also said it got better. The problem went away as it got hot, which is kind of interesting, really. Kind of backwards from what you usually find with leakage problems. So kind of ruled out a leakage problem. Like if the seal in the brake apply were bad, you'd end up with leak by all the time, and typically thicker oil leaks by less, so you could get the brake to release when it's cold, but it would stay on when it's when it gets hot. So what I want to show you here is, we'll go over to the manual for a minute, and so here is the valve that I removed. So we'll go over to the more of the functional schematic here. So oil in here, oil in here, and then it goes down, and there's our motor. So what this does is, it takes, when it sees pressure on one side from the pump, it takes the oil, routes it around here to the end of this, like a pilot signal, and shifts the spool valve one way or the other. When the spool valve shifts, it's supposed to connect the pressure from either side down along this line to release the brake. See the little spring behind the piston there, and it kind of shows like what I guess should be a brake shoe. So when you put pressure on this side, that gets pushed back and it releases the brake. Now, once everything returns back to neutral, it has to drain this brake so the spring can apply. So it drains it back through the motor case drain and back to the tank ultimately. So we go up here, and it shows us that we have valve port A, valve port B. Got a little light problem here. Let me move. Motor port B, motor port A. So, and then pressure to release the valve, and then tank. Now, so what you get out of that is, if we go back over to the main valve here, to the actual valve as it sets. So this is the back side. This is the side that bolts to the motor. If you put air into it, so we put air into this side here. I'm sorry. This is gonna be a bit tricky with only one hand. But let's think of it this way. This shifts back and forth. So oil comes in here, a little bit of it gets diverted to the end, comes out this port here, into this cap out there, puts pressure on the end of this, and drives this that way. Okay. And then the other side does the opposite thing. Now, considering the way this works, is so we can say that when this valve shifts one way, it needs to connect the pressure in one port to the brake valve port. Then it needs to connect the pressure in the brake valve port to the tank when it's centered. And then it needs to connect the pressure valve port to the other port when it's in the other direction.
So it tests out as it works. And this is floating free, so I don't really see anything necessarily wrong with this. And this is what had me stumped for a little while.
I'm going to do my best to try and hold the camera while I do this here. That's not going to work. So here, I'll shift it and give it some air. So that's coming out this port here when I blow in here. If I shift it the other way, it blows out. Oh, I shifted it too far. Blows out. Comes out the port facing me. I shift it the other way. And it comes out the port on this side. And if I put it dead centered, it's coming out the port right here. So this port checks out as our
motor brake
port.
The thing is now, when I come over to my motor here, so that's the port
directly in between the two, not the one that's lower.
So if I take that port and I look at this one,
the minute I blow air into this port that matches up with that one, hear that? Hear all that bubbling in the tank? And all the noise coming out here, that sounds like a case drain. Now, if I blow into this one, I just get straight leakage. It's hard. It's like a blown into a wall. Now,
another little point to look at here. This port goes in, and I can feel it. It's open all around in there. Down. Up. Left. And right. Okay, and I can move that all around in between.
So that goes into an open space, like a case drain, the case of the motor. Now this one, I can go in on the side,
nothing.
Go in on the other side, nothing.
Going up, right, nothing. If I go in with a little, aha, there's a port that goes straight down.
So this gets cross-drilled down. Now, if we go back to our book here.
So, we're on the valve page.
We're gonna fast forward here to the motor. This is the swing motor. I need to get to, there we go. If you look here, number 20 is our brake pack. That's our discs.
This little thing on the end of my finger there, that is the brake piston. And behind that is the spring.
So they show it up here a little more clearly. So that would be 21 is the spring, 38, 37 are the seals. And so what happens is the spring pushes this piston into the brake pack and compresses it, locks it. To release it, the oil goes between that little seal and that little seal, those two little seals, and pushes that piston back, compresses the spring. Now that gets its oil from this little passage here. See that 50?
So if we go to 50, what does it say, socket? Well, nope.
I'm reading the wrong number. It's a restrictor. That has to do with your brake release and apply, sort of speed isn't too fast on it. But if we go back to what we're looking at here, see, this has to come up from the bottom. The other one kind of probably goes into the end of the shaft.
And that would explain the cavity. This one, so I think that this valve
was possibly assembled wrong, brand new. And instead of putting pressure into the valve, it was putting pressure into the case. And only after case pressure became high enough to start thinking about releasing that valve, did it ever release it. And case pressure would get higher as it gets hotter because there's more leak by. So it makes sense. Now,
I did look at this valve, and it looks like it is. So you can see how these ports line up now. Okay, so this little pinhole connects to this. This little pinhole connects to that. So, and then there's these slots that would, see how that connects both of those holes?
So, see if I can get it in a position. Here we go. So if I slide this way at all, so this port disconnects from that one. So that means these two stop sharing oil.
And this hole is lined up into that port. So oil, pressurized oil from here goes into this port. Okay, so that's neutral, they're connected. So these two, one's tank, one's brake. So the brake's applied, shift it this way. This connects to that, pressure here.
Valve here, brake here, brake's released. Slide it the other way.
Now this slot's still connected here, but it's not connected to that one. So pressure comes out of here from this. Here's your pressure into that, brake's released. Now,
if I take this whole thing and I end for end it, okay, it's built symmetrically
to the point where if I shift it, let's see, there we go. Okay, there's
centered right about now.
So if I shift it this way,
yes, shift it that, that's the center, or shift it that way,
this should be able to be flipped. So I'm going to flip this valve and install this back onto the machine and see what kind of results we get. Trying to get this thing to work. I'll talk to you in a minute.
And success! Look at this job. Get to bring it in nice and easy, bring it right up to speed. Oh yeah. A little shaky there. Sorry about that. We got backwards. We got forwards. We have no trouble transferring between directions. Which before to do this, if I got it going, by jerking it around, I can get it to go. So, here we go. All set for another day's work. Got to button up the panels. Send it on its way.